Let's start with this first section here. So this is a kind of like a very simple intro style section. Consists of a kick and a bass line and a simple hi-hat loop. There is a kind of like a filter intro thing where the kick and bass is first filtered out and then going into the full bass range here. So I wanted to choose this because it's so sparse. It doesn't have much in it, so we can try out a few different things and see what we're gonna do. I wanted to create something simple to begin with, nothing too advanced, nothing too grandiose, and just some kind of mini hooks, something to add to the character of the track, to add to, you know, fill out some of the gaps, but not something that's gonna take a lot of space. So yeah, let's begin. I'm gonna loop this region first, and just to remind ourselves how this sounds like. Again, this is a filtered out kick and bass. Starting to come in and hits at 9. Okay, great. I'm just gonna go ahead and show the clip launcher again, because that's usually what I use as a sketchboard. For this exercise, I'm gonna go with the old polysynth. This is kind of subtractive synthesis, something that many of you are probably very familiar with. This is a standard kind of analog style synthesizer with two oscillators, a filter section, some blend options of the different oscillators, and a way to create some modulation of the filter using the oscillators. There are two envelopes here for amp and for filter, so it's fairly straightforward. So what I usually start with is finding kind of the rhythm of the sound. The next sound, I need to find where it goes before I think of how it sounds, essentially. So with that in mind, I'm just gonna let the beat roll. Bah. Yeah, that's where I want to have it. So even without any listening to the sound in any way, I'm just gonna go ahead and launch this clip, and I kind of know just from that where I need to put it. Actually, I need to check whatever tone this is in. Okay, this is a funky choice of bass tone. It needs to be this. This is a kind of a classical rhythmical thing to do, is to make them bring energy into the rhythm, bring, you know, a lot of movement, is to play something just short of the first bar. In this case, I'm playing it 1/16th. Is it 1/16th or is it 1/4th? Whatever, you know what I'm talking about. Just creating some urgency in the rhythm. Just gonna loop this first section here so I don't hear the bass all the time and get fatigued with it. So this synthesizer has got a default setting. Just gonna do some tweaks here and see what, if something interesting happens. Very classic Francy sound is, of course, to do like a pitch modulation. I use the built-in modulation system in Between Studio to do this, adding an envelope and assigning it to the pitch. Mm-hmm. I don't want to have a sound that's too wild out there. I just want to have something to support, bring some rhythm into it. Maybe it's a sound you don't even think about when you hear it. It's just there. Yeah, I kind of like that dryish thing. So to begin with, I'm working with very short loops because that, I mean, I can hear it all more often. That just speeds things up. I'm gonna make this twice as long. Okay, so I got a tiny little thing going on here. So I think I found the sweet spot here, and I'm gonna leave it as it is for now, and then we can build some variations and things. Let's add a dynamics, kind of keep the volume in. Try to bring up some unison to make it stereo wide. It needs to be a little bit longer. And it should definitely be mono. Okay, so I think I've got the basic rhythm, but I don't think it needs to happen quite as often as it does. What am I going to do here? I'm going to double this and these two. Do this, mute this for now. Add an LFO to bring some movement into this. Slow moving. Gonna modulate the filter cutoff and the length of the filter envelope. Let's leave the loop, see where it takes us. Make this pink. Okay, that was going into the other section, but just wanted to check what happened. I need to make this twice length again. Gonna remove the first high one. What are we gonna call this? We're gonna call this the short Squelch. Yeah, that's good. So starting from like a one bar loop, I made this into an eight bar loop with some tiny variations. So the first bar, it's only the one squelch, and then the one squelch again, because I muted this. I'm gonna delete this. And then third bar, there is some more action going on, and then it develops like that. So putting this into the context of the arrangement, I am gonna hide something so we see what we're doing. I'm gonna remove the modulation here because it kind of leaves the sweet spot and I don't like that, so make it more static. I think that's more useful. Okay, so we just made our first sound and this is now helping the first section get going, fill up some gaps. I think it's not necessary to have it in the second part because that's already so crowded with this huge blue sound, but let's just hear it for a second. Yeah, it just disappears completely. We'll remove it for now. Maybe we'll put in part of it into it later. But anyways, I want to keep it here in the end because telling a story, we want to tie the different sections together, and repeating sounds that were part of the first section in the second one helps to tell that story and kind of bring the track together into one story. So okay, then that happens, and now going from the break. I don't know if you noticed that, but it sounded totally different when it played here. Even though it's exactly the same sound, just in the context of the other things, the sound just sounded way different. At least in my ears. Maybe I'm hallucinating. But that kind of reminds us how important it is to listen to things in context and how important it is to have sounds that go together and play in harmony. I need to fix this somehow. So I needed to fix that. I didn't like it actually in the end, and I wanted to make it more percussive and less muddy. I think this is nicer. It's more unique. It's more weird. It's more percussive and frog-like. Okay, so here's the trick. If you found a sweet spot, but you're not sure you want to commit to that and you're afraid you might mess it up, add a macro instead. I'm going to make this bipolar, assign it to the parameter, in this case the cutoff. And now instead of touching this, because I don't want to touch this because I think this is the sweet spot and I don't want to mess it up, I can try variations using this instead now. And I can always just jump back to the value that I liked. Okay, so when I'm going down in frequency here, there's a lot of bass information, so I need to add an equalizer to filter that out. I'm just going to solo this for now while I'm doing this cutting work. And it's a simple sound, so I don't need to add like a fancy, huge equalizer. Just going to take the simplest equalizer there is and just cut out the bottom end, essentially. There's also the... Okay, this is actually working maybe too heavy. And you'll notice that when I go up, the perceived volume is much, much louder, much higher. So I could either put in like band in the equalizer to equalize that out, or I can assign the same macro to the volume knob. Just a tiny bit. Well, that's not tiny, but let's see how this happens, how this sounds. So when I go up in frequency here, I simultaneously go down with the overall volume of this device. Problem is here, because it's a bipolar macro, that means I'm also going up. So that's why this is not working really well in this particular case, but maybe I can EQ that out. Yeah, I'm going to call that a success. How do we make the sound move? Where do we start? Where do we end? Where do we want to go? I kind of like it when it's static, but I want to have some movement. I'm not sure how to solve this, actually. Let's fool around a little bit and see what happens. Okay, so I like how that sounds and how my control of that. I've added a random modulator that changes value every time there's a note to a random value. And I'm assigning that to the macro, so it can go up and down when a note hits. I have the control over how much with this knob. And my idea is I want to keep it static in one part of the song, and then I can slowly increase the randomization to get more and more movement. Okay, I think that's a pretty good idea. At this point, it's maybe time to introduce something called remote controls. And these are built in into every device in Pitwee Studio. I'm going to go ahead and add an empty page here. Because this knob is hidden inside the modulator, and it's kind of a nuisance to have to kind of go in and find it every time, because that's something I'm going to use. I'm going to just map it to my remote control doing like this. Now I have the amount available directly from the remote control, and it will also work out fine when I do the automation that I will show you in a second. Let's call this mod amount, just to be clear, or Okay, so let's try this. Let's keep it static to begin with. Here, let's bring in some randomization. Okay, so we can do a pretty normal standard curve here. I think that works fine. What I like to do is whenever I do a sweep like this, I'll just bring it down to the base value afterwards, so I know when I'm start to play from here, we'll be back to where it was. Which works fine, because there's so much going on here anyway. Which reminds me, this is actually the thing that I changed. So I'm gonna move this over. There we go. That's it. Let's save.